And welcome back, valued viewers. Here we are with a new game. This is Aviary Attorney. Yes, these two words don't usually go together. Aviary, where you keep birds. Attorney, where you keep lawyers. But that's what we're going to do today. We're going to explore the interesting and crazy world of being a bird lawyer in 1848. It's January the 1st. It's Paris. We are at the Chateau Crinerie of Baron something. I didn't read it fast enough. And we've got a dead frog. Oh, dead frog. Oh, is that Monsieur Grenouille? Oh mon Dieu. Oh mon Dieu. Il est mort. Dame Cataline, what have you done? What have you done, Cataline? Act 1, a cat with claws. What is occurring? What is occurring? Oh, who's this? Oh, is this us? Okay. Sparrowson. It's midday already. Where on earth is that featherhead? Oh. Well, well, well. Look who finally decided to get up. Haven't you heard what they say about the early bird, Falcon? Falcon. Ugh, too early for worms. Pass the Cabernet Sauvignon. There'll be time for that later. We've got some business to handle first, says Sparrowson. Business, says Falcon. Oh, what's this? A letter arrived while you were sleeping. I haven't opened it yet. It's probably just more junk mail. Go ahead, Sparrowson. You may have the honours. All right. Dear Monsieur Falcon, I am writing to you today because my daughter, Dame Gateline, has been arrested for a crime she did not commit. We'll be the judge of this. She is being held at the Conciergerie prison on the charge of murder, oh, no less. Her trial is in 3 days' time. I would be greatly in your debt if you would offer her your legal aid. Oh, very interesting. Yours sincerely, Signor Bertois Demieu of the Demieu estate. This French is going to be hard. it's just hard. Falcon says, well, this is quite something indeed. He's got his little bonnet on. He's got his nice falcon face. And he's dressed as a gentleman of the court of France in the 19th century. Are these little? No, they're not. Okay, and this Sparrowson, they were quite something. I know. Your first serious client in months. No, just that. The Demieu estate is well known for its exuberant wealth. Even if we cannot do much for Dame Caterline, his lordship will still reward us handsomely for our efforts. Well, not if she gets put in jail forever. Wow. So I suppose you intend on defending Dame. Is it Dame or Dame? Dame? Dama? Madame? Dame Cataline in court. Defend her in court? Kind of think so. Or do we say no because we don't know whether she's guilty or not? Do we say of course? Is it wise to defend people we don't know what they've done? But we're going to say of course. Because we're positive and optimistic at the moment. Of course. It would be foolish to let such a good opportunity slip through our feathers. It's going to be a lot of bird jokes. Grab your coat, Sparrowson. We're going to find our kitty client at La Conciergerie. Conciergerie. Is she a cat then? I don't think you go and see her if she's a cat. Excellent. Mon derrière was getting tired from all this sitting around. Oh, but I better file away Signor Demieu's letter first. One moment, Falcon. Bertois's letter has been added to your evidence folder. All right, okay. You may access the evidence folder at any time by clicking the suitcase symbol. So a folder is a suitcase. Okay. Nearly forgot my wallet. Wouldn't want to lose that, says Falcon. Sparrowson. Again. I recall you losing it at the New Year's party and at Christmas. Yes, all right. No need to make a list. Falcon has picked up his wallet. Square brackets for some reason. 20 francs. Oh, sorry. 20 francs. Here comes that. Oh, what's this? Oh, It looks like one of these typesetters boards where you can put all the letters for your making your print. We got the letter. Legal aid for the daughter, Cataline, held at the Conciergerie. And we can put more things as we find them. And in here we got 20 whole francs, which back in the day is good money. You may see how much money he is carrying at any time by clicking on the wallet symbol. I think he's got 20 francs. Okay, let's make a move. On y va. Allez. Ah, c'est Paris. Janvier the 3rd, Lundi. Welcome to the map screen. There it is. From here, you can travel to any listed area by clicking on a location name or a location node. Areas marked with a clock symbol take a whole day to visit. We've only got 3 days. Areas with no symbol can be visited freely. What are these squares? Le conciergerie. I keep wanting to say le concierge and then stop, but I'm going to put erie on the end. AA offices or avian attorney offices. A sign on the door reads the avian attorney offices. No case too big or too small. No jungle. No cold calling. No Jehovah's Witnesses. And for centuries, the infamous concierge erie prison has detained the accused and the condemned alike. It seems. I want to see a clock. Means it will take a day to get here. How's that going to take a day to go from there to there? I mean, these are blocks of buildings. It's like, I mean, that's half an hour walking. But I'm not here to be judgmental yet. I'll save that for later. So where are we? This is the Seine. Is this the Seine? This looks like the Palace of Versailles. I do not see. Do I? Trying to get my directions going on. That's the Palace of Versailles. This has got a special name, and I should know it, but I don't. Anyway, Falcon and Sparrowson step into the stone-cold foyer of the Conciergerie prison. Oh, sullen-faced guards and visitors linger beneath the medieval archways. Classic fan vaulting. Nice. The Conciergerie. They say this is the finest prison in the whole of France. What do you mean, finest prison? Does it get 5 stars on Yelp? The outer walls are impenetrable. The cells are spotless. The guards are well-mannered. This is all very fictional. Quark, there is. What sort of bird is that? Is that a cormorant? He says, "Would you want?" Good day, monsieur. I am here to see Dame Catherine de Mieux. I am due to represent her in court. Oh, you're her lawyer, huh? Fine, follow me, says Quark, which is the name of a Belgian beer. Well, what are you waiting for? Oh, that's Quack, actually. What are you waiting for? Keep up, he says. Nice, classic. Oh, she's a cat. I think you should be very careful as a bird. What's this? Sigh. My papa hasn't forgotten about me, has he? Maybe I should do that in a girl's voice? No, okay, I'm not going to. There's Falcon, there's Sparrowson. Dame Catherine de Mieux, I presume. You've arrived. The fantastic lawyer, Monsieur Falcon, and his petite assistante, Sparrowson. I want to do French accents as well now. Milady is knowledgeable. He kind of sounds to me like he's some sort of Cockney from London. I'm getting Parker from the Thunderbirds from this guy. Milady is knowledgeable. And this guy's French. Don't talk like that, Sparrowson. Sorry. My papa told me that he would only hire the best lawyers in town. You've only got one, but okay. I'm flattered. Get to leave. But they weren't available at such short notice. So we hired the first people in the address dictionary, directory. Oh, because he's AA, isn't he? The comedy gold. You see, Falcon, I told you listening under Aviary Attorney would pay off. That's very good. So, avocado and abacus seeds also do well. Let's get down to business, says Falcon. Dama Catherine, could you fill us in on some details? Your father's letter was a little brief. I can do my best. What is it you wanted to know? Ooh, okay. Let's start at the top. What happened on the night of the murder? What exactly happened on the night of the murder? Falcon repeats, rather redundantly. Ooh, let me think. It was Friday evening. Me and my papa, do people actually say papa? Had arrived at Chateau Crinery, the home of the great Baron Rogil. My papa, can we call him? No. My papa spent all evening talking with Monsieur Grenouille and the Baron about business stuff. Business stuff? Well, the three of them own a railway company together. I think we should memorize all this stuff. So all through dinner, they were talking about company shares investments, but I didn't really understand most of it. But after dinner, this man with a camera took our photograph. Wow. That was a lot more fun. Sorry? Man with a what? Took your what? Oh, they didn't know about cameras back in the day? Oh, look, it's a classic. Is that the box brownie? No? Oh, look at this thing. I quite like photography. Camera, it's a very new gadget. A tiny bug sits on a box. Sits in a box with a tiny paintbrush and paints your picture very fast. Marvellous, that's how they work. In 10 minutes, poof, you have a perfect picture. Marvellous, wow. Technology is amazing, says Sparrowson. I don't think the lady's explanation is right, Sparrowson. Oh, right. Let me believe, Sparrowson says. Still, the camera sounds like a very special device. I'll make a note of it. Camera has been added to your evidence folder. Camera. A photographer named Robitio, who knows, attended the banquet. So we've got a classic camera, we've got a letter, we've got a camera. Okay, that's evidence, is it? Right, evidence to the evidence folder. Please continue, Dame Catherine. So after we had the photograph, I went into the gardens to get some air, and that's when I found the body of Monsieur Grenouille. Ooh, he was all ripped open. Oh, he's the frog. Oh, of course, a French frog is Grenouille. A housemaid saw me standing over the froggy monsieur and called for help. And then the police arrivaient. And before I could say anything, I ended up here. It was such a blur. It must have been terrifying, said Falcon. It wasn't so bad. My papa taught me how to be a brave cat. Was there something else you wanted to ask, Monsieur Falcon? Yeah, we're moving on. I like the dinky noy, dig, 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 dig. Okay, who was there? Who was there that evening? Well, the music is by the composer Sansen, who's of the Romantic period. It's classical piano. Dame Catherine, who attended the banquet that evening? Well, there was me and Papa, obviously. My dearest Maman couldn't make it. And there was the Baron Rogil, who hosted the dinner, and his housemate. Oh, very suspicious housemate. Couline, I think she was called. I think all of these are puns or jokes. I'm trying to work out Couline, what does that mean? You have a coulis, which is a type of reduced fruit syrup. Of course, there was Monsieur Grenouille, who's a frog. Well, until, you know, he died. Exactly so. And there was Monsieur Robitio de Robinho. Is he a frog as well? That's like ribbit, ribbit. The man with the camera, but he was only there for a little while. I'm thinking there's a frog vendetta going on. Hmm, said Falcon. I think that was all. Was there anything else you wanted to ask? Did you see anything suspicious? Dame Catherine, did you see anything suspicious that evening? Falcon asked redundantly. Suspicious, says Catherine. Like maybe a guy lurking in the shadows. Or a bloody murder weapon. Or some guy, you know? Monsieur Falcon, I do believe you're looking for an easy answer. Well, maybe. You got me there. I did not see anything, I'm afraid. The evening was very normal, the food was delicious, the conversation was boring. A classic night. It was all very ordinary until the incident, I see, said Falcon, I see. Wait! Falcon, you missed something of huge importance. Have we? I did. Dame Catherine, you said the food was delicious. But you didn't say what food it was! Why is that important? You and your damn stomach. Let me see. We had poached red herring. Red herring. Classic red herring. To start garnished with garlic butter. Red herring with garlic butter. Herring with garlic? I'm not sure about that at all. That's not classic French cuisine, in my opinion. Maybe some sort of blonde roux, maybe a bechamel, who knows? Maybe a velouté, but garlic butter on a herring? Go on, says Sparrowson. Oh, what we got here? What is that? Then a marbled steak served perfect, bloody rare. Okay, yeah, that's fine. That's very French. So they'd be medium well. Sorry, medium rare. That would be more French, medium rare. A glorious Falcon, write this down. What? This can't possibly be relevant to the case. Sparrowson, write it all down, please. For me. Fine, fine. Red herring. It's literally a red herring. We've literally got a red herring. Can we look at them? Can we examine them? I'm Robert Robitio, and red herring. Yeah, that's classic red herring. garlic butter on red herring, on herring. Yes. Oh, and bloody rare steak. They're normally medium rare. Has been added to your evidence file, where is it? Now, Dame Kathleen ate a bloody rare steak at the banquet. Right. Good to know. Sparrowson, remind me not to let you talk to clients on an empty stomach. Yeah, there was his eyeballs there. Come to think of it, I did find it a little strange that we weren't given any cutlery. You weren't given any cutlery? No cutlery? Even for the steak, how do you eat the fish? Nope. You would have thought that the great Baron of Chateau Criniere would have gorgeous silverware. Mm-hmm. But there was none to be seen. Very, very suspicious. This is probably my most suspicious thing so far. That is a little peculiar, says Falcon, underestimating how peculiar that was. Was there anything else you wanted to know, Monsieur Falcon? No, I think that will be all. So what's the plan now, Falcon? The way I see it, we have two tasks. We should head to Chateau Criniere and try to see the scene of the murder for ourselves. And we should try to track down this supposed photographer, Monsieur Robitio de Rubinho. He's got me a frog, in every sense of the word. 2 days for two tasks. Seems doable, says Sparrowson, who is kind of lazy, but I like him. We should get back and get some rest first. But we have a lot of work ahead of us, says Falcon, strangely. Oh, but wait, Monsieur Falcon, before you go, says Catalina. You do believe my story, don't you? Do we? Well, yeah, you're at the party, you're reading some stuff, you find a good dead guy, yeah. I mean, so far. I believe in justice. Three dots. All right, but do we believe her? I mean, are we gullible and believe everybody? Not really. Do we believe a good-looking woman who tells a story of intrigue and murder? In these sort of situations, she's usually involved in some way, shape or form. Blankly say nothing, because if people think you're a genius, why disabuse them of that opinion? And we say, I believe you. Of course, Dame Kathleen. It is our duty as lawyers and as gentlemen of the French people to have faith in your testimony. You can trust us. Merci. Merci. Motu. And lovely engraving there. So out in the fan vaulted room where you can get, what does that say? E-F-F-E. C-O-F-F. It's not coffee. Coffee? Don't know what that means. Let me know in the comments if you know what that word is back there. Dame Catherine, Monsieur Grandouis, Baron Roguil. These names are getting a bit confusing, aren't they? Yes, indeed. Catherine, we know, is the girl. She's a cat. Monsieur Grandouis, he's the dead guy. He's a frog. Baron Roguil, haven't met that guy yet. And we know the other guy, I think, is a frog. Robitio Rubinho. Okay. Not particularly. Well, it is for me. I'm going to start compiling a Facebook. A book of faces. So I can keep track of everyone. A what? A Facebook. It's a collection of people's names, pictures, and descriptions in one easy-to-carry catalogue. I think I understand. The name could use a little work. Yeah, go with the Facebook. Sparrowson started compiling the Facebook. Oh, look, we've got them all. JayJay Attorney, you've got a picture of yourself so you know who you are. If you don't even know who you are, then you shouldn't be a lawyer or a detective. We've got Sparrowson, Falcon's suave and courageous lackey. What a handsome fellow. He looks like a sparrow. That's why it's called Sparrowson. We've got this Pertois de Mieux, the wealthy father of Dame Catherine. Pertois hired us to defend Dame Catherine in court. Okay, a nice coat. We've got Quark, the ill-mannered jail keeper. Seems to feel disgust for criminals, and why not? And for animals in general. And we've got Dame Catherine herself, the elegant bourgeois daughter of Seigneur Pertois de Mieux. She has been accused of murdering Monsieur Grandouis. And we've got Monsieur Grandouis, the froggy businessman, in every sense of the word, who was found murdered at Le Chateau Criniere, a colleague of Pertois, and Roguil, which we don't have so far. Where's Roguil? More pages? No pages. Oh, more people to talk to. Okay, fantastic. You can access a list of people you've met at any time by clicking the book symbol, just like that. Let's make a move, says Falcon. Nice engraving. where are we now? We a new day. Start of a new day. We've got Studio de Rubinho, Chateau Grenouille. But you can also make quick save at any time. Clicking save and quit from the pause menu. Access it by the cog symbol. What that thing? Oh, I've resident escape key. Oh, okay. So, Studio de Rubinho is here. Chateau Grenouille is up here near Versailles. Is that Versailles? I'm still saying yeah. We've got the conciergerie, the prison, and we've got our offices over there. So, where are we at the moment? Are we here, I guess? Oh no, it's a new day, so we went home, so we're going to here. But these take a day to get to, do they? We can't go to there again, and that's where we live. So we've got to go to one of them. How come they take a day? She's only got 3 days. Let us go to the scene of crime. Dun dun dun. Falcon and Sparrowson enter the courtyard outside Chateau Grenouille. People with dirty clothes and gaunt faces linger around the building's shadows. Okay. Excuse me, monsieur. Sultan? Sultan. Why is she called Sultan? From the French word to jump. Is she a kangaroo then? Excuse me, monsieur. I don't mean to be a pain, but my little girl and I are sick and starving. Starving? See? Okay. She's a cockney. Don't mean to be a pain, but my little girl and I are sick and starving, see? Cough, cough. Says the little kangaroo. I don't suppose you'd happen to have some spare change, governor. You have 20 francs in your wallet. What will you do? Oh, I thought that was she's saying. I thought that's very, very, very knowledgeable. Could we don't give nothing, give 1 franc? 10 francs. I think we've only got 20. I think we give 1 franc. There you go. Here you go. Stay safe, madame. Many thanks to you, dear messieurs. That was pretty generous of you, Falcon. Not really, it's only 1 franc. Times are tough. Making sure a mother and child have something to eat is the least I can do. Exactly. So, well, what am I doing standing here moralising? Come on, Sparrowson. We've got business to attend to. I'm not sure what would have happened if we'd given her 10 francs. Maybe she would have said, I've got a secret for you. And one wasn't enough, maybe. Falcon and Sparrowson step into the pristine wood-panelled foyer of Chateau Grenouille. Yeah, very nice indeed. Very nice indeed. Yeah, it looks like Windsor. Oh, Windsor Palace. Really nice. Well, look at this place. Baron Rogil must be loaded. More than loaded. When it comes to lucrative investments, the Baron is a legend. Factories, chocolate shops, hotels, the railroads. The Baron owns a little bit of everything. This side of the Seine. Is he here right now? I don't know. Yes, he's the smug-looking chap with the impressive mane. But we must approach a man of this stature with tact and finesse. Hey, Baron! We'd like a word, says Sparrowson. How's that? Sparrowson, you have the finesse of an inebriated warthog. You can thank me later. I think I got his attention. Oh, hello. Check this dude. Rogil. What's lion in French? Lion. Don de Lion. Lion is just Lion. Did I hear my name? Great Baron Rogil, a property owner extraordinaire at your service. There he is. And who might you fellows be? More investigators, that's right. No, we're attorneys. Not quite. I am private attorney JayJay Falcon. And this is my associate, Sparrowson. Lawyers, eh? You know you ain't the first to have passed through here today. Oh, says Falcon. Yes, yes. This jumpy, twitchy fellow came by this morning, asked a bunch of questions, hopped away before he heard the answers, most curious. Says Sparrowson. Do you know who he was, Sparrowson? Why would Sparrowson know who he was? Perhaps. I have a hunch. We'll be seeing him in the trial. Oh, I see. You think he's the prosecution lawyer. A friend of yours? Something like that, says Sparrowson. Rogil, so what may I do for you, messieurs? We're doing some research on Monsieur Grenouille, the frog who was killed here on Friday evening. Of course. And d'accord, such a tragedy. He was a good friend and a loyal business partner. I suppose you messieurs will be wanting to see the crime scene for yourself. Actually, yes, that'd be fantastic. Well, be my guest, you'll find the garden where the murder occurred through the back doors. You may also be interested in the lounge on the second floor, third door to the right. Don't think they used the word lounge. I think it was a salon, but okay. That would be where we gathered for a group photograph, again, prior to the murder. Oh, unfortunate incident. Oh, can we see the finished photograph? I'm afraid not. It is to my understanding that a photograph must be developed before it can be viewed. It's a slow process. Not really that slow. I mean, development of a photo, you're looking at maybe 30 minutes. My own copy of the photograph is to be delivered in 3 days. 3 days' time? Was it 2.5 days of sitting around? That's no good to us. The trial may be over by then. Nonetheless, we appreciate your hospitality, says Falcon. Thank you, Baron. Snipper, trouble, door. I'll be here to see you out when you're done with your investigations. So where should we go first? So we've got garden, main hall, lounge. She said, Mayor Kathleen said that he was found on the steps in the garden. I say we start there. Dame Kathleen says she's found Monsieur Grandville on the stairs by the fountain. So this must be the very spot where the murder took place. Oh, look at this place, it's nice. Classic. What is this? Neoclassical? Neoclassical style? Like you very much. Very good. Hey Falcon, do the crime scene investigation thing. What is this? Like the 1990s? The crime scene investigation thing. Yeah. You know the thing where you get all eagle-eyed and analyse every object in excruciating detail. Okay, let's do that. Okay. You mean search for everything? I do. Yeah, let's do that. That's not a bad suggestion, says Falcon. It wouldn't be the first time the Parisian police have missed something right under their noses. I bet that's the situation. In investigation mode, you are free to examine the scenery of the room. Click on an item of interest, and Falcon will examine it in closer detail. When you've had enough, or when you can find nothing else to examine, click on the X in the top right corner. Select an area to examine. I see. We have little zones. Let's start with the actual fountain. Fountain is finely crafted, solid carved marble, can't have been cheap. Probably bought from Italy. I see nothing but water in the bottom of the lower basin. It's a shame we can't see inside the upper basin from here. This thing. That'll be the perfect place to quickly stash a murder weapon. That's it. That's actually not a terrible line of reasoning. We ought to wade in to take a closer look to just to be sure. Yeah, I suppose we should. Oh, I apologise. I wasn't being direct enough. By we, he means you. So, Sparrowson go wade into the fountain. Take a closer look inside the upper basin. God damn it, says Sparrowson. Me? No way. If you want to go wading, do it yourself. Sparrowson, get your ass up there. Do some work. I'm a respectable lawyer. You can't expect me to roll up my trousers, paddle around the fountain like a duck in a lake. A goddamn duck. Does he look like a duck? No. Off you go then. Well, well. You don't pay me enough. Do we pay you at all? I don't know. To justify getting my sweet threads. Sweet threads. Is this the 1980s now? Look. Look here now, Sparrow. There's only one reasonable way to sell this. Go and do it. We'll flip for it. Flip for it. Oh, there's a coin. Yes, I'll flip this one franc coin. Is that a franc coin? I don't remember them looking like that. Is that Napoleon? That's why I don't remember it. That's Emperor Napoleon. Wow, that's a franc from back in the day. Okay, I'll flip this one franc coin. You call the outcome. Get it wrong, you go for a swim. Get it right, you go for a swim. So will it be? Heads or tails? Napoleon's face or plant squiggles? That's right. I always go for tails, don't know why, because I'm a contrarian. Plant squiggles, it's called a wreath, Sparrowson, look it up. Sure, I'll bet on the plant squiggles. Okay, here we go. It's heads. Should have gone with the old Emperor Falcon. Right. Okay, hold my shoes. We're not going in there, are we? Hold my shoes. Falcon really should learn how to spot a rigged coin flip. Jesus Christ, Sparrowson. You sneaky bird. I almost feel bad for cheating. No, what Chancellor. What a Cockney Chancellor he is, almost. You're back. What is he, that on his head? I had a good swim. No, I'm a bird, not a fish. You are a bird, you could have flown. What have we got here? But I did find a mystery item in the upper basin. It's no murder weapon though. What is it? It's brown and sticky and it's a stick and it smells weird. Don't tell me you picked up a stick. What's brown and sticky? A stick? Very wet cigar butt. They've usually got a paper wrapper on them that says something like Cohiba or Cuban or something. Possibly belonging to Baron Rogil, correct. Does he smoke? Does he not smoke? Why would he chuck it in there? Who knows? But that shouldn't be too surprising. It's his house after all. I'll stash it in the evidence folder just in case. Cigar butt. Cigar was found at the bottom of the fountain. Rogil's garden could only be reached with a little wading. Okay, I don't know how that helps us as yet. Is there anything else we need to do here? Yeah, we've got loads of stuff to look at. Let's start with this little statue. Horse statue. You know, my uncle once had a horse that refused to eat hay. Sounds like a setup to a joke. How did it eat? It refused to eat hay. Oh, that's unfortunate. Yep, eventually realised that it was just filling up on hors d'oeuvres. Hors d'oeuvres. Horses, d'oeuvres. Horse d'oeuvres. There's a lot of double puns going on there. there's hors d'oeuvres, obviously, but there's horses, d'oeuvre meaning egg, so horse eggs. When does the horse lay eggs? Moving on. That's terrible. This is fucking... selected. What do we learn from that? Nothing. Nothing. There's another one. More jokes. A horse statue. This one has got a goofy face. That reminds me of a joke. Horse walks into a bar. The barkeep says, "Why the long face?" Yes, we've all heard that one. What? No. The barkeep says, "You've got to stop coming here. You're drinking us under the stable." He's frozen. I think it's time to rein in these horse jokes, says Falcon. I think we've all got that. Right, another. We've had some jokes. We've had some lols. So we've got two up here. What's this? yet again, finely crafted horse statue. The mane looks almost lifelike. Would you say it behooves you to stroke it? No, I would not. No. This guy thinks like I do. Like, no, I would not. So let's have this one up here. Baron Rogil likes his horse statues. I don't mind the horse statues, but the little cherub people creep me out. What cherubs are these? Yeah. Aren't they types of angels? You've got cherubim and nephilim. And the cherubim are the smaller ones, and the nephilim are the bigger ones. I don't mind horse cherubs. Babies should be waddling, not attempting saddleless horseback riding. Yeah. I don't think they're actual babies as such. They are angelic entities or something. That's basically what they are. So we need to examine. Dried blood on the staircase. This must be where Monsieur Grenouille died. Do you see any bloody footprints? Or maybe a name scrawled in blood, written with the frog's last breath. Wishful thinking, says Falcon. All I'm seeing here is a big sticky puddle. There's nothing to indicate the body was moved or that the frog had a last minute clue. All I can make out from the bloody mess is that Monsieur Grenouille was attacked and killed on the staircase. We know that already. Is that... I kind of think there's going to be something that we need to actually find rather than horse jokes. Because what do we know so far? We know there's a cigar, we know there's blood on the stairs, and we know that there's a lot of horse statues. I'm not seeing anything. The mouse is not changing at any point. Do I have to click on things? Don't think so. Oh, the adventures of the Aviary Attorney. I kind of think that's it. Alright. I think we're done. Good call. But are you sure you don't want to take another dip We still have time. This guy's funny. Don't push your luck, Sparrowson. You Cockney Sparrow. All right, let's go to the salon. Oh. It's a giraffe. Sparrowson, Falcon, second floor. Third door on the right. This must be the room where the photograph is taken. I've got a clock, I've got a giraffe. Hey Falcon, you see that? What, the giraffe? See what? That housemaid totally did something shifty. How can you tell? She's right up there. Shifty. I think she just pocketed something from that drawer. You should totally call her out on it, because that's what giraffes are known for, their pickpocketing skills. Excuse me, mademoiselle. Ah. Yes, it says Colleen. Are you two policemen? No. No, no, no. We are private attorneys. My name's JayJay Falcon, and this is Sparrowson. Oh, how rude of me. My name is Colleen Duho. So, what can I help you, messieurs, with today? We're investigating the murder that took place last week. Do you mind if we ask you a couple of questions? That's fine. Let's just grab a chair. And it's better. What is it you wanted to ask? Says the giant giraffe. Is this where the... that's all. Is this where the photograph was taken? We're looking for the room where the photograph was taken prior to the incident. Would you happen to know whether this is the right room? Oh, yes, you're in the right place. I saw the photography session for myself. Let's see. The cameraman was standing over there. Just about where you're standing, actually, monsieur. Uh-huh. So standing here in front of the clock. And Monsieur Falcon. And where was the camera pointed? Right at the clock above the mantelpiece. Mantelpiece? Clock. The Baron insisted on using that very location. Uh-huh. Now that I'm looking at it, something isn't right about that clock. One. Does that look like two? Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. Where are the hands? There's no hands. And we've got some guy with a pipe reading a paper, maybe? But there's no hands, which is a bit of an issue. I know, the painting on it totally clashes with the decor. I wasn't thinking along more obvious lines. Clock has no hands, he says. Oh, that clock has never had hands in all the years I've worked here. I think Baron Rogiel just keeps it around as a conversation piece. Why would you have a clock with no hands? Why would you stand here, take a photo of the said clock? Oh, that is one suspicious clock. Well, we're conversing about it, so I guess it's working, says Sparrowson. Now, it's a peculiar detail, though. I'll make a note of it. Missing clock hands have been added. Missing clock hands. 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, yeah. Although, that's Roman numerals, and these are Arabic numerals. So these are like normal numbers. And those are Roman numerals. But okay, added to the evidence folder. Coolie, is there something else you wanted to ask? Yeah, why did that happen? Okay. Is there something we should know? Nice, vague and open question. You were a little nervous when we came in, Mademoiselle Giraffe. You thought we were police officers. Is there something you want to know? Anything you need to confess? Did you murder the frog? No, no, no. I suppose I'm just feeling a little nervous after all the drama of last week. Pressure, pressure, pressure. Are you sure there isn't something that you're hiding, you giant giraffe person? It's okay to tell us. We're defense attorneys. That means we help people get away with criminal acts. That's exactly what defense attorneys do. But no. No, it isn't. It's like, what if someone walks down the street and just comes up to you and says, the police come up to you and say, right, you're under arrest for murder. And you're like, what? They say, yeah, you're under arrest for murder for the murder of Pete Jones, 300 miles away. And you're like, I don't even know Pete Jones. They say, well, it doesn't matter. You're under arrest. Then you need a defense lawyer to, like, represent you. So, because you've done nothing and you don't know anything about it. So, yeah, it's not just about getting away with criminal acts. It's also defending people who need defense. But that's my opinion. Right, and wait, what? No, that's not an accurate job description, Sparrowson. It isn't? So, well, what do we do then? I'll tell you later. I just told you what they do. Honestly, messieurs, I have nothing to hide. Was there something else you wanted to ask? Said the giant giraffe. And is that all we did? We did pressure turn, then backed off and started arguing about the job spec of being a defence lawyer. Okay, that's all. No further questions. Merci, mademoiselle. You've been a huge help and a huge giraffe. It's no problem, messieurs. Actually, there is something. Oh, I know you two saw me stealing. As you came in, I appreciate that you didn't give me the third degree about it. You see, I'm trying to save up to follow my dreams. And well, never mind, I'm rambling. It's no problem, mademoiselle. To be honest, we have a much larger crime to worry about. We don't know what she stole. And she's in a room where things are being murdered. This is not, oh, she's nicked £20 from the till. This is stealing something from a murder scene, in the murder scene. Mademoiselle, can I look at the thing? If it's money, you can have it. If it's not, I want to know what it is. Although I should probably ask, I don't suppose you've been stealing anything else, silverware, perhaps? I don't care about silverware. It's not our problem, silverware. You know about that. Yes, I suppose that was me. It started with a couple of teaspoons. I didn't think the Baron would miss those. But, well, yes, I suppose the habit got a little away from me. That's one mystery solved, at least. There's no cutlery in the whole place. People are going to dinner and there's no cutlery. I wouldn't fly in 18th century France. Missing silverware has been added to the evidence file. Look, we've got some silverware now. Couline, housemaid of Chateau Crunerie, has confessed to stealing houseware from the silverware from the household. That doesn't help us though, does it? I mean, it'll help with the dinner later. I would appreciate it if you didn't tell the Baron. He's been really kind. Hate to break his trust. But how people can eat the red herrings if there's no cutlery? They can't eat the steaks if there's no cutlery. I see. So where to next, big bird? You talking to me or the giraffe? All right, let's have a look in the main hall. Nice thing there. We've got you. Did you, messieurs, have a good look around? I trust everything was in order. Says Rogue. We had a good look, thank you, Baron. We actually have some questions for you. And you, Monsieur Lyon. Please ask away, I have nothing to hide. Nice silver-topped cane, like it very much. About your housemaid? We met your housemaid, Couline de Hout. She's a courteous young lady, isn't she? Yes, she's quite helpful. She's more than willing to help us with our investigations. Glad to hear of it. Did you two want to ask something else? What happened on the night of the murder, Baron Rogiel? I would like to ask about your activities on the night of the murder. Oh, am I in trouble? Not at all. No, nothing like that. We're just gathering the full picture. I see. Well, let me think. Go on then. All right. The guests arrived at 5 o'clock. How do you know? You've got no clock with hands on it. And we all sat down for dinner at this very hall at 6. Okay, an hour of standing around. That part went magnificently, apart from the cutlery. The photographer arrived at 7. It wasn't until 7:30 we had our picture taken. 5 to 6, 7 to 7. Okay. My housemaid discovered the crime scene soon after that. I see, said Falcon. Is there something else I could help you, messieurs, with? We'll be leaving, are we? Okay. That will be all, Baron. I thank you very much for your time. It was a pleasure. Have a delightful day, messieurs. Well, what did we learn from all that? Housemaid stealing cutlery. Stealing something from the room where the murder was. The clock's got no hands. And then it's a different clock face when it's in the actual evidence folder. Very strange. Murdered frog on the stairs. Blood on the stairs. Lots of statues of horses. And a cigar, which is wet. So someone was on top of that fountain smoking a cigar. How does that work? The fountain was off. You can't smoke a cigar if the fountain was on. So the fountain was off. And they're smoking a cigar up there. And the murderer was a fish. I don't know. It could, because the animals, there's a whole freakiness of the animal thing. Anyway, Sparrowson, did you get all the information you need, Falcon? I hope so. Don't worry, if everything goes wrong in the trial, we could always just wing it. Terrible, just terrible. Would birds constantly make bird jokes? I mean, humans don't make human jokes all the time. But anyway, terrible is terrible. Let's head back to the office, get some rest. And we're back, January 4th. Janvier 15. We've been to these. We need to go to Studio de Rubinho de... it's this one. Can't say his name. Where are we now? Studio of the famous photographer. Why is he famous now? Should we knock? He's taken one photo so far, but it was at a baron's house, so maybe. And photography was very new at that time. Shall we knock? I've got a note on the door. Let's have a look. Wait, there's a note on the door, says the eagle-eyed Sparrowson. The magnificent and marvellous artist, Monsieur Robitio de Rubinho, is currently out on an artistic expedition. Very suspicious indeed. He shall return when his muse fees sit. He shall return when his muse sees fit. Is he talking about himself in the third person? Because that's just bizarre. When his muse sees fit. What does that even mean? I don't know, when he feels like it, really. I think it means that he's a pretentious bird brain. Indeed. But in any case, the artist seems to be out. What should we do now? Break in. We should knock anyway. We should knock anyway, says Falcon, very wise. All right, I don't see the harm of knocking, says Sparrowson. Knock, 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 knock. Nope, doesn't look like he's in, Falcon, which is what the note says. We should break in. That's right. We should break in. What? Shut up, Sparrowson. I mean, if you want to find out facts, you've got to take risks. You've got to do the bad thing. You've got to be the guy on the street. Maybe. Monsieur JayJay Falcon, I would have thought that a man of justice like yourself would be against such reckless displays of unlawful barbarism. Good sentence, I liked it very much. But needs must when there's a murder and an innocent woman is going to be put to the guillotine. Or maybe. You're right, I'm sorry. What? Break in. It's a brilliant suggestion. Stand back, I'm barging the door down. All right. Have we not got lockpicks or something? No. Wait, just like that? Shouldn't we discuss this further? You suggested it, dude. Excellent. What in Bird Jesus' name is that? Bird Jesus. I can't even imagine Bird Jesus. You said you wanted to break in. We did indeed. I thought we could find an open window. I didn't think you'd turn into a bird-sized cannibal. Well, now we're here, we ought to make the most of it. This place is quite something. It's very... It's nice. It's really nice. It's not quite fan vaulting. I don't remember what this one's called, but I like it. Swanky. Yeah, it's nice. There's a name for this stuff. Swanky. I was going to say ostentatious. Okay. That's swanky talk for swanky. We don't have time for this. The sound of the door being smashed in could be drawing unwanted attention. I'm liking the music at the moment. We should find anything that may help our cause and get out. Select an area to examine. Statue of a horse? Painting of a horse. I see a finely dressed dandy fellow upon a horse. Right. What's that? A lighthouse? No way, it's a man with a top hat. Actually, if I squint my head, it's a black smudge, Falcon. Well, let's get closer then. You're in the room. There's a lot of paintings. Paints, inks and dyes. Not quite sure what the clear liquid in this bottle is. Put it on a rag and hold it up and see if it smells of chloroform. I could taste test it. I like your insanity and bravery there. Are you good? We don't have time for a hospital visit right now, so let's not. Well, so there's a clear liquid, could be of any description. Bourgeois tigresse in the profile. I like the word bourgeois. Bourgeoisie. Lots of painting. Oh, a chandelier. You should get one of those for the office. I don't have the money for that sort of luxury. Okay, we're going to have to go through all the pictures. Photograph of a ladder, symbolic of climbing towards success. Looks more like a step ladder to me. Oh no, we're not getting into all that. In that old argument. Step ladder. Don't you say you're carrying a ladder? No, it's just okay. A beautiful picture of the Parisian skyline. Given the angle, this must have been taken from Notre Dame Cathedral itself. Notre meaning Ah, and Dame meaning Lady. Our Lady Cathedral. Fantastic. Something to do with Notre Dame, I'm sure. What's this? A butterfly? Maybe a moth? It's difficult to sell in black and white. Why is it black and white? You're in black and white. You're in the room. This is a photograph of a castle somewhere in the countryside. You're making it up. You're just making stuff up. You know, I once had an uncle who once fell off a castle rampart. Oh, God, you too. I'm sorry to hear that. Did he die? No, he got demoted. Sparrowson's a legend. Terrible. Stop dissing Sparrowson and his puns. Let's look up here. There's a tiny photograph of what appears to be a jail cell. You're just making things up. That reminds me. How illegal is this? Breaking and entering. Well, it's burglary, I think. Unlawful entry into a property. You don't have the intention of stealing or GBH, so. Breaking and entry. Rifling through a person's belongings. It's very illegal. I'm not going to lie to you, Sparrowson. For court, we'll be spending 20 years. 20 years? You don't get 20 years for it. With a number instead of a name. I call 24601. 24601. There's probably something to do with that number. 24601. 10642. Maybe it's a line. 24601. If you know what that means, 24601, let me know. Don't be dark, Sparrowson. Can't call prison numbers. Damn, I want that one. So they both want the same number. There's a picture of a fence. Could be literally anything. I bet you could say it's a picture of a fence photograph. It leaves the viewer defenseless. Out of all the pictures here, I would have picked it. Pick it as my favourite. Okay, I'm done. No more fence puns. No, they were good. Keep cracking on. I don't even know what we're highlighting here. So look, that looks like a picture. What's he going to say? That's a picture of, I don't know, two people walking on the German hillsides. Picture of a sailing ship. On a windy day. Brilliant. All right, over here. Hey, Falcon, look. What? It's just an easel. No, it's not. I don't know. Look what's on the easel. Ha ha. Oh, wow. This must be the copy of the photograph from the evening of the murder. We have Papa. We have, what's her name? Kulin, the giant giraffe. We've got Lady Cataline. We've got the clock with no hands. And what else do we know from this? What else do we, what do we glean from this? The housemaid, Dame Cataline, and I think that's Seigneur Patois, Cataline's father. Yes, indeed. That's what I thought. So what should we do? Can we just take this? Yeah. We've come this far. We may as well borrow it. Studio photograph has been added. Can I examine things further now? Is there anything else we need to do here? Move on. Some antlers there. I'm dubious to move on because I'm sure they're going to say, ah, you missed the two people on top of the Ormolu dresser. But no. I think we're done snooping. Let's get out of here before the police turn up. That sounds good to me. It's embarrassing. Okay. Uh-oh. Oh, mon dieu. What happened to my door? Oh, it's him. Rubinia. We don't know, mate. We came here. It was like that. Tell the truth, lie. 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 Lie. Some kids did it. Weasels. Goddamn weasels. We saw them. Yeah, weasels. They were like, yeah, let's break into this art guy's house. He's a douchebag. And we were like, no. No weasels. Can't do that, man. Don't do that. He's a nice guy. Can't do that because that would be illegal. And they were like, shut up, man. We chased him off. That's the important thing. Well, thank you, I suppose. Yeah, that's all right. Gullible guy. Let's make a move. Trial day is approaching fast. Let's have a little look at this this crafty weasel while we're here. Alrighty. Right, let's go. We're not going to ask this guy questions as we're here anyway. No, we're just off. We don't care about asking him anything. Palais de Justice, is there? We've seen all these things. It says January. We're burning through time here. We can't really go back. We've got to go to the Palace of Justice. Falcon and Sparrowson stand inside the marble portico of the Palace of Justice, awaiting the opening of the Tribunal de Grande Justice. I think we're going to have to leave this for now and come back for episode 2 of the great adventures of Aviary Attorney.